Lesson 71. He's awfully. 第71课，他讨厌透了。Now first, read the new words and expressions after me, please. 首先把这些生词和短语跟我读一下。Awful, awful. Telephone, telephone. Time, time. Answer, answer. Last.Last, phone, phone, again, again, say, say. 首先来看第一个单词 awful, awful, 它是形容词，表示坏的。如果说多么糟糕的书写呀，我们知道书写是 handwriting. What awful handwriting? What awful handwriting? 多么糟糕的书写呀！I had an awful day. I had an awful day. 表示我这一天真是太糟糕了，我过得不是很好。I had an awful day. The weather is awful. The weather is awful. 天气糟糕极了。这里面 awful 是形容天气不好，天气坏。我们在 awful 后面加一个 ly 就变成了副词，它的意思是非常、极为，表示 very much。说天气极热。It's awfully hot today. 今天天气极热。It's awfully hot today. 那么 awfully 在这里表示非常、极为。下面我非常抱歉。I'm awfully sorry. I'm awfully sorry. 我非常抱歉。awfully 在这里面形容 sorry 表示非常、极为。Okay, now read after me, please. Awful. What awful handwriting? I had an awful day.The weather is awful. Awfully. It's awfully hot today. I'm awfully sorry. Number two. Telephone. Telephone. 做名词的时候呢，它表示电话机。说我的爸爸昨天买了一个新的电话机。My father bought a new telephone yesterday. My father bought a new telephone yesterday. 那么在这里 telephone 表示的是电话机。接下来我想不起他的电话号码了。I can't remember his telephone number. Telephone number 在这里面是表示电话号码。Can't remember 表示记不起、想不起。I can't remember his telephone number. Telephone 还可以表示电话。Answer the telephone 表示听电话、接电话。那么 telephone 我们以前也讲过啊，它除了可以做名词之外，还可以做动词，表示打电话。The awful man always telephones me. 这个讨厌的人总给我打电话。The awful man always telephones me. 这个讨厌的人总是给我打电话。OK, 那么 telephone 在这里面是做动词，表示打电话。OK, read after me, please. Telephone. My father bought a new telephone yesterday. I can't remember his telephone number. Answer the telephone.The awful man always telephones me. 来看一下第三个单词 time, time, 名词表示次、次数，它是可数名词。那么我们来看下面这样一个结构：基数词加上 time 的复数形式 times, 表示几次。那么它必须表示的是两次以上的次数。我们来看下面几个例子：三次 ，three times, 四次。Four times, 但是一次和二次就不可以用 time 这种形式来表示。一次我们说 once, once, 两次 twice, twice。我们来看下面一个例子，他今天上午给我打了三个电话。He telephoned me three times this morning. He telephoned me three times this morning. 在这里面 three times 表示的是三次。那么下面的一个结构和它不一样，是序数词加上 time。 大家注意，这个 time 是单数形式，它表示的是第几次。我们来看一下 The first time 表示第一次， The second time 表示第二次，那么第三次 The third time 是序数词加上 time。 大家注意，这个 time 应该是单数形式。那么 time 可以表示次数之外呢，它还可以表示时间。 如果表示时间 ，time 就是不可数名词。大家注意一下，你现在有时间吗 ？Do you have time now? Do you have time now? 你现在有时间吗？我没有时间做它。I don't have time to do it. I don't have time to do it. 在这里大家要注意一下 ，time 表示时间是不可数名词。OK, now 咱们再看一些和 time 有关的一些短语。All the time 表示一直。我使劲地找这封信，而它就一直在我的书包里面。I looked very hard for the letter, but it was in my bag all the time. I looked very hard for the letter, but it was in my bag all the time. 在这里面 ,all the time 表示一直。On time 表示按时准时，比如说火车准时到站。The train is on time. The train is on time. On time 表示准时按时。我们每天都按时上学。We go to school on time every day. We go to school on time every day. For the time being, for the time being 表示暂时。如果说我暂时不想见他 ，I don't want to see him for the time being. I don't want to see him for the time being. 暂时我们还不能决定。For the time being, we can't make the decision. For the time being, we can't make the decision. 那么在这里。For the time being 表示暂时。OK, time 我们就补充到这里，下面我们把学过的一些关于 time 的词组和句子再学习一下。Time, three times, four times, once, twice. He telephoned me three times this morning. The first time, the second time, the third time.Do you have time now? I don't have time to do it. All the time. I looked very hard for the letter, and it was in my bag all the time. On time. The train is on time. We go to school on time every day. For the time being. I don't want to see him for the time being.For the time being, we can't make the decision. Answer. Answer. 它表示对什么什么做出反应、响应。谁接的电话 ?Who answered the telephone? Who answered the telephone? 我们讲过 answer the telephone 表示接电话。玛丽拖了几分钟时间才回去开门。玛丽拖了几分钟的时间才去开门。Mary took a few minutes to answer the door. Mary took a few minutes to answer the door. 那么在这里 answer the door 表示去开门。接下来 answer 做动词还可以表示回答、答复。那么我想大家对这样的一种解释比较熟悉。我们来看几个例子。我认为你没有回答我的问题。I don't think you've answered my question. I don't think you've answered my question.Answer the question 表示回答问题。下面 I wrote him several letters but couldn't get an answer. 我给他写了好几封信，可是都没有回音。Get an answer 表示回信、回音。那么回信我们可以说 answer the letter, answer the letter. 接下来 answer 做名词，做名词的时候它表示答案或者是解决办法。我们来看一个例子。Do you know the answer to question 10?你知道第十题的答案吗？那么在这里 answer 表示的是答案。This is one of the possible answers to today's environmental problems. 这可能是解决当今环境问题的方法之一。那么在这里 answer 它的意思是表示解决办法。This is one of the possible answers to today's environmental problems. 这可能是当今解决环境问题的方法之一。OK, now read after me.Answer. Who answered the telephone? Mary took a few minutes to answer the door. I don't think you've answered my question. I wrote him several letters but couldn't get an answer. Answer the letter. Do you know the answer to question 10? This is one of the possible answers to today's environmental problems.接下来我们看第五个单词 last, last, 形容词表示前一次的。我们来看几个词组。昨夜 last night, last night, 上周 last week, last week, 上个月 last month, last month, 那么上个夏季我们可以说 last summer, last summer, 去年 last year, last year。 last 做形容词还可以表示最后的、末尾的，比如说五月的最后一个星期天， the last Sunday in May, the last Sunday in May, 那么最后一个星期天 the last Sunday 在五月是 in May, 因此五月的最后一个星期天就可以说 the last Sunday in May, 那么最后一次 the last time, the last time。 OK, 那回过头来我们把这些单词再读一下。 last, last nightLast week, last month, last summer, last year, the last Sunday in May, the last time. 接下来 number six, 第六个单词 phone, phone, 名词电话，它的意思和 telephone 是一样的。 OK, phone, telephone. 下面 again, again.副词表示再一次、又一次。如果说再说一遍 ，say it again, say it again。我们何时再见面 ？When can we meet again? When can we meet again? 我们何时再见面？下次不要再发生这样的事情。Don't do that again. Don't do that again. 这样的事情以后不可以再度发生。This must never happen again.This must never happen again. 那么如果说 again and again 表示屡次的、再三的、反复的，那么指身体或精神恢复常态，我们可以说 be oneself again, be oneself again, 恢复常态。那么 oneself 是反身代词，表示某某人自己。 OK, read after me. Again, say it again. When can we meet againDon't do that again. This must never happen again. Again and again. Be oneself again. 最后一个单词 say, say, 动词，那么它强调的是说话的内容。 OK, 那我们单词就学到这里。